Hello and welcome, everyone. This is Zachariah 1688 with another We Fail At. This is, once again, the Kerbal Space Program. I do believe this is episode 7. Yay, lucky number 7. Getting up there to the double digits. Woohoo! Yay, new YouTuber. Star Program. All right. Today I'm actually going to be getting on into orbit on camera, and hopefully with my audio on. Just going to check it there. There we go. Yeah, it's on. We're going to be using the same rocket we did last time. I do believe that was the Bogey 610. I'll go ahead and select. Now, while I'm sitting here doing a once-over, trying to make sure all these brackets here are hooked on and ready to go so we don't completely shake apart on our way up there. I have received a few questions, and thank you very, very much for all the comments and the likes I have received on my videos. To be honest, I didn't expect any comments nor that many views. I expected views from just random surfers, but thank you very much for the comments. I have considered new games or different games new to my YouTube, but not necessarily new. Main one being something that's probably a little worn and tired by now, but Minecraft. I do have a copy I've played since Alpha, so love that game very much so. I do know that if I do a Minecraft video, I will probably make it a story-driven video, or series, I should say. Maybe not necessarily just me talking to you with a commentary like this, but I do also have, yeah, everything's good, go up here. I do also have a Steam account, so I have a few things like Mount and Blade and its expansion slash full extra installment of a video game, of course it's a video game. I do believe it's Fire and Sword. If I do post videos of those, they will be done as multiplayer videos only. While I find that it is a very good game, a very fulfilling game, the story mode on Mountain Blade is not exciting if you, unless you do it right, and I don't think I'm experienced enough to do it right just yet. Let's see. Throttle up. There we go. Get ready to lift off. And I'm going to cut here, and we'll be right back as soon as I get higher up in orbit, because you've seen a launch 1,000 times by now, I'm sure. Talk to you later. Okay, everyone, we're back. I have achieved a bit of an orbit. I will show you that in just a moment. I'm going to go ahead and maneuver myself properly. There we go. Get a little bit of that. That right there. Okay, that's looking nice and sexy. Alright, let's go to here. Alright, as you can see, I have a dark blue. It's a really low orbit, but hey, it's an orbit, right? My periapsis, which is the slowest, fastest point that I'm at, is 38,000 meters. And my apoapsis, which is my highest, slowest point, is at 300 and dropping, because I'm actually in the upper atmosphere. There we go, it's 200 and something meters. That's going to drop even more so until I continue to leave atmosphere, if I continue to leave atmosphere. Let's hope I do, right? I am in orbit. While I'm here, I'm going to toy around a little bit with my RCS thrusters, try to get the hang of these. I'm going to need these a lot if I want to try to go to the moon, right? Alright, 90 degrees, and let's go ahead and kick in a burn. Still have plenty of fuel left. I have less than half a canister on here, and a full canister left on this stage of my rocket. I forgot to engage my SAS. I am such an idiot. Alright, pardon me for that, YouTube. And right there, engage, thank you. I still have one full can of RCS thruster fuel left. There we go, working on the last rocket, fuel tank of this stage, and then I have another two fuel tanks on this stage, on my final stage, but that, slow down, don't want that much of a Apioapsis. See, that's increased just a little bit, but this is nuts. That is 1.5 million and shrinking slightly. Meters. I am most definitely from the States. I got to get used to this metric system. Okay. That is quite a distance away. But let me show you the. That's what my orbit looks like. It's kind of a slingshot egg. I get here, speed way up, and without using any fuel from my engines, speed way up and thrust all the way back out to here, slow down, slowly start to speed back up coming over here, thanks to the gravity of Kearth, and then shoof. With this video, or possibly next two videos, since this one seems to be running a little over half my time here, I'm going to be making just one loop around the planet, and then I'm going to try to land it back. Here's hoping, right? we know our luck here at We at Fails. I have to admit, though, this is absolutely beautiful here. This is a gorgeous place that the game creators have made. All right, let's go back to here. Kind of zoom out a little bit. That's a nice view of the ship, and then a strand of the Milky Way there. Well, I don't know if it's the Milky Way we're in, but I like to think so. All right. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. There's the sun setting. See the small aurora borealis going on over there? That's nice. Okay, well, I'm just going to turn my SAS off for now and just kind of coast. Alright. There we go. Don't know if I've talked to y'all about this yet, but I currently use Bandicam, as in case you can't tell in the top center of the screen, as my recording device, my primary recording device, and with it I use Microsoft LifeChat 3000 headset. That's all I use. I have the audio reverberating in my ear right now to try to make sure I can match myself and remove my accent as much as I possibly can, so that way y'all can understand me. Bandicam Free, which is what I can afford, currently only offers 10 minutes of free available recording time. If you are a very kind and loving person, or not, either way, but if you know of another free recording service, such as Bandicam, or I'm not familiar with anyone else. Like I said, I'm new to this entire recording scheme. But if you know of another free recording service, please let me know in the comments. As I've talked about earlier, if you have any game in mind that you would like for me to talk about or possibly put on my YouTube, please also let me know in the comments below. To those of you that have taken an interest in my channel, thank you very much. This has gotten to be a very, addicting hobby of mine. I really like making these videos, even though right now they probably look so boring on the screen, but hey, it just gives me someone to talk to. But I'm going to have to cut this into two videos. I will talk to you later, and y'all have a very wonderful day. Bye, YouTube.